I'm Susan Harbison, and we are in the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute in the Clinical Center in Bethesda, Maryland. I'm interested in human sleep disorders, insomnia, that's the inability to either fall asleep or stay asleep, narcolepsy, which is the inability to control the transition from the waking and sleeping state, obstructive sleep apnea, which is a loss of oxygen to the brain, which causes people to wake up periodically during the night, restless leg syndrome, which is sort of a tingling, uncomfortable sensation in the legs that people often experience. As a child growing up in Cary, North Carolina, I was very interested in how things worked. I was really curious. And so I would take different small appliances like tape recorders and stereos and things like that and just take them apart. And I would leave the pieces for my parents to find, which sort of irritated them a little bit. My first degree was in aerospace engineering. And so I worked on military aircraft for a while. I did some maintenance of aircraft structures. And around that time, the Human Genome Project had started, and I got very intrigued by genetics. And I realized that some of my computational and mathematical skills that I had learned as an engineer could be applied to genetics. So we study sleep by looking at sleep in the fruit fly, Drosophila melanogaster. Yeah, these guys are interesting. So fruit flies are a very powerful model, and it turns out that they sleep just like we do. And some genes change their expression with changes in the environment. And you probably have experienced this yourself. If somebody left the lights on all night, for example, I wouldn't go to sleep. So you can manipulate the environment in different ways with the flies and see how the genes actually interact with the environment. It turns out I have a tube here. This is just a little monitor tube, and I'll show you the monitor. So there's one little guy in here, a little fly going in this little glass tube. It has food at one end and yarn at the other. And this is what we stick into a fly monitor, a sleep monitor. And the monitor has an infrared beam that bisects the tube. So when the fly walks back and forth, he breaks the infrared beam. And that gives us an activity count, which is recorded on a computer. And we can take that data and very easily calculate the number of minutes that the fly's spent awake, how long he's been asleep, what his average nap time is. So I'm gonna sort these flies. I'm gonna anesthetize them first of all with just carbon dioxide. And then I'll sort them into two different groups, male and female. So we keep them in little culture vials, and then we transfer them to those tubes when we're ready to make the sleep measurements. Put them down in there. And there they are. The overall goal is to define conserved gene networks. And what I mean by conserved is a gene network that is operating not only to control or regulate sleep in flies, but also in other species, and in particular humans. The actual size of the data and the analysis is very complicated, and so it helps to have more than one person doing that. It would be very labor intensive for one person to do by themselves. So I saw in this paper some new analysis that we might want to try for the RNA-seq data. I think that this has a really interesting statistical method that we might want to try out for that data to try to understand what's going on.
Okay. I think, we already developed a very good workflow for our current project.
Here's what they've done. And then they have them arranged here in this network, and that shows us how those genes are going to interact. This data is very complex. It has a lot of nuances, and the answers aren't very clear cut. So for me, it's sort of like looking for buried treasure, right? You're always trying to find the answer. And that's what I really enjoy most about it. That's what brings me into work every day. So I would say the best thing to do is to go get hands-on experience with people in the field. And there's a lot of opportunities. We offer some at NIH where students can come for the summer, and they do a real research project, and they get some exposure to the lab, but also to the culture here, in that they get to attend seminars and learn more about research.